For design, it's communication. Like that's, no matter what position you're in, from all the way at the bottom, all the way to the top as a designer, you have to be able to communicate your ideas and be able to understand the information that's coming back to you from the people that you're talking with. So many times we've had people or situations where improper communication or lack of communication caused lots of rework, and that is gonna frustrate everyone, so.
Okay. So elaborating on that just a tad, all types of communication, verbal, written.
Yes, absolutely. And like a lot of people don't think about things like public speaking for design, which is super important. That actually came up this morning in conversation. Like there are times where you have to get the idea, you know, out to a lot of people. So you'll stand up in front of your entire team and kind of present something. And if you're not able to do that in an effective manner, then you're going to have issues.
Mm-hmm. Great.
Mm-hmm. Do you want me to answer? I haven't been a senior animator in 2 years, so I'm not sure if you want that answer or the answer is what I'm doing now.
I think whichever you prefer, or both.
Okay, a little bit of both. Okay, so I was senior animator for 12, 13, 14 years or whatever. Now I'm Chief Creative Officer and co-founder along with Elbert here. In the animation aspect, animation is interesting because there's not one skill that I can say transfers perfectly animation. It's not like, oh, well, I did this as a kid, so I'm gonna be a good animator. It's kind of a combination of acting, a combination of directing. You know, you're directing your characters, but you also need to be able to know how to act. And of course, there's these more mysterious skills like timing and all the other principles of animation that you have to work on that you're probably not gonna really even learn until you start to animate. So, my current job, it's more of working as a producer type or animator's fine. I'll be an animator today. most people here are going to school for something more like being an animator developer. So today I'm an animator.
That's a proud good answer.
For technical and programming, I'd say problem solving, because you need to have the desire to solve problems, because as an engineer, your task is to solve the hard problems. There is no problem that will be easy. And you know, if I say, like, hey, work on this, and you say, oh, that's too hard, then I'm like, well, why are you working here? You know, you're supposed to be like, yeah, I'm gonna take on that challenge. I'm gonna do that. You know, give me a day or give me half a day. And that's really what being an engineer is about, is solving the problems.
A lot of my experience has been as a technical designer. You know, kind of one foot on the programming side and then one foot on the design side. And so over the years, what I feel like I've kind of come to the conclusion of some of the most important skills for that area, if technical design is an area of interest, is that it's kind of at its core, it's a support role. And so you need to have the same desire, like Elbert was talking about, to want to solve problems and know how to solve problems efficiently, you know, figure out process of elimination, do all of those types of things which can be learned. But then there's some things which are a little bit more tied to kind of you as a person, personality, like do you find fulfillment in your work by it being something that enables somebody else, but you know, maybe you're direct output is not something that, in the case of games, shows up in the game, but you know that your work made it possible for a number of people to do more meaningful work that did directly impact the game. And so for some people, that is a very fulfilling thing, and that's a really important thing to both understand, but also to foster if you want to do, you know, tech design and support type roles.
Wow, I'm so glad I went last, because I'm going to answer as a producer, because that's really what I do, but, you know, made up my own job title. A producer is all these things. So you communication is your most important skill. You have to be able to solve problems, but you're in a support role. You're really just doing whatever needs to be done every day to get the job done. For anybody who's wants to be a producer, I'm going to break the myth of a producer as like some lofty, cool job who, you know, you get to be on TV. You are the lowest role at the studio. Your responsibility is everyone else's happiness, and so you're kind of a servant to them. Unless you're the AP, you are the lowest role. But other than that, the producer is the lowest role. They're serving QA, they're serving everybody. So your most important skills are gonna always be your soft skills, because your responsibility is the people, more than it is the product or the processes, it's the people. So I would say communication and kind of empathy and problem solving are all probably the most important things for being a producer.
Awesome. Thank you, gentlemen. I would say to all the students here and all the students watching, really think about that. A lot of the coursework that you're going to take in an undergraduate or a graduate program is going to focus upon really specific technical skills. And that's wonderful, and it's necessary, but that means that when you get into courses that do address these soft skills, that get you communicating and get you problem solving and, you know, develop your empathy, thank you, that's such a huge piece, really dig in and take advantage of that coursework, but also find places outside of your coursework where you can work to develop those skills.